films is most familiar to modern audiences as Randolph Duke in Trading Places. Mortimer, we're back.
Good to see you back. I started to get a little concerned here.
Wait, who is that over there?
I don't know.
This is Kurt. He works for the Ant-Man. Kurt, what are you...
Well,
I wondered what you were doing. This is very important. Kurt, are you, like, you defeating a security system somewhere? You did it? What exactly did you do?
I have achieved highest level for Candy Crush.
Ladies and gentlemen, David Death Malchin! It's so great to have you here, and could you tell a story? I did not know you were a big fan of mine.
I am. It is such a pleasure to be here this afternoon with all you wonderful people, and I gotta say, I moved to the fair city of Chicago, and I was raised and born and loved the great horror films of the past. And I used to watch Home and the Information Morning when I grew up in Kansas City.
Sure.
So I was looking for my new outlet, and I discovered you one day on television, and my eyes were hypnotized by what you were doing, and I've been hooked ever since.
That's so cool to hear. And of course, everybody loved your performance as Kurt and Ant-Man. It must have been a great deal of fun to work with Paul Rudd.
Yeah, Paul is amazing. He's one of the most fun people I've worked with. As you am a diehard comic book fan,
sure.
As I am a horror movie fan, so getting to be a part of the Marvel Universe is a dream come true.
That's cool, and not only the Marvel Universe, but also the DC Universe, because you are a confederate of the Joker in The Dark Knight.
I was born to play a thug, as Bob would say. I was one of the Joker's henchmen, and I actually got to have a really fun, cool role on that film, which was such a blessing in my life, and really changed my life, but as you can imagine, for someone who's lived in the world of the comic books for so long, to then step on to those sets and get to play with people like that, it was, it's been a dream.
Yeah, with some of the biggest characters in comics. That's pretty
Batman.
Amazing.
Yeah, you heard of him.
You might have, I don't know.
Yeah.
That's so cool. And you got your start in commercials?
I sold everything. You want me to sell this? I can sell that. This is a really handy-dandy little keypad there. I was doing cell phone commercials for Singular.
Uh-huh.
I did a commercial where I went Jimbo, Jimmy Boy, Jimster, and then a lot of burger commercials for the good old Wendy's comic.
Oh.
And it's funny, and I love looking back on this because I made some great friends there, but the truth is it's how I learned to act in front of a camera, because I grew up watching Lon Chaney Jr., Boris Karloff, Bela Lugosi, Vincent Price, you know, Peter Lorre, huge heroes of mine. But I trained in theater.
Uh-huh.
So getting in front of the camera and doing commercials was a huge learning experience for me.
That's terrific. And I know that you've done the movie Animals.
Yes, Animals, a movie that I wrote. We made ourselves. We actually came here. We shot not too far from here. We were shooting near Berwyn.
Never mind. It's all right.
And yeah, that's available now. You can watch it online. You can go by my house. I've got a stack of DVDs I'll gladly give to you. But no, please check that one out. And then doing a movie we wrapped recently in South America, we shot called The Belko Experiment.
And that's a horror film.
Yeah.
Ooh, you too.
It's really fun. There's blood, there's guts, there's all those things we like to see.
And directed by Greg McLean, who did Wolf Creek,
wow,
who I love.
Yeah.
And James Gunn wrote it and produced
sure,
it.
Sure, that's
and
very...
I get to play with Michael Rooker, who's
oh,
a
boy.
Favorite.
That's yes. Gotta be great. And you also worked with a friend of ours, Mark Hamill.
I mean, another person, you talk about heroes. They say don't meet your heroes.
Right.
Well, in this case, I highly recommend if he's your hero, meet the guy, because he's one of the kindest, sweetest, smartest, most talented people of our time. And I got to play with him in this movie called Sushi Girl.
Wow.
And we were sitting on set getting ready to do a scene together, and he was incredibly gracious. And we bonded over our love for the classic Vincent Price film, The Tingler, a William Castle staple.
Sure.
I go to a place called the Cine Family in L.A. where they show it every year with the seats rigged to tingle.
Oh.
And they bring in a nurse and they carry someone out. And Mark and I, once we started putting together our love of film and of you, the bond was set. He's a great friend.
That's so cool. I love the fact that the theater actually does the whole William Castle experience.
They do it all
with all the gimmickry stuff.
The warning and everything. We got to bring that back. I said,
I
let's make a movie together where people's heads explode, and then when we're in the theater, we'll actually rig people's heads to explode.
That sounds like something we can get to, but I know you've got a very special role that you can't really talk about coming up.
Yes, besides this one.
No, of course.
I'd love to come back. I'm going to come back tomorrow and every day thereafter.
Okay,
but when you want to have me on the set, we'll talk about it. Just make sure and bring some cherry pie and a cup of coffee.
Cherry pie and a cup of coffee? Could that be a hint? Well, I don't know, but we're happy that you came here. David Desmalton, everybody.
It's back on. No, this is not the game. This is your web browser.
Don't look at my history.
I will never look at you same again.